Good afternoon, family and friends. Let us stand as we begin this Mass and prepare our hearts to receive Jesus in Holy Communion. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you. As we enter the journey, this is the perfect number of First Communion candidates, 11, just like at the Last Supper, because Judas left and the other 11 stayed. And so it is Jesus, my friends, who calls you to himself to receive him in Holy Communion for the very first time. And so we give honor and praise to God, for he calls us to himself. I invite Matteo and Emily to come forward for our welcome.
Long, long ago, in a far distant place, God planted a garden. It was a beautiful garden filled with every kind of fruit and flowers. In the cool of the evening, God would walk in the garden, but it was a lonely garden, so God lay down beside a quiet stream. He dreamed, and the dream came true. He dreamed of us children, the most beautiful creation in his garden. Sometimes thought, though, his children lost their way in his garden, so he sent his son Jesus to look after them.
We are his children, and Jesus is our shepherd. On the night of the Last Supper, Jesus gave his body and blood to his apostles. Today, Jesus invites us to a wonderful banquet at his table. This day is special. It is our very first Holy Communion.
Indeed, this is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. As we begin this Mass, let us bow our heads, for the times we fail to realize that Jesus is right here with us, and ask his mercy, for he is slow to anger and abounding in love. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You were happy to die on the cross to free us from our sin. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Now risen from the dead, you lead us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Spirit. so that rejoicing now in the restored glory of our adoption, we may look forward in confident hope to the rejoicing of the day of resurrection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us be seated and listen to the Word of God. I invite Harlan forward for our first reading.
Thanks be to God.
They are not hard to follow. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The disciples from Emmaus told what happened on the road and how they knew that Jesus was the Lord when he broke the bread. When Jesus' disciples were talking about what had happened, Jesus appeared to them and said, "May God give you peace." They were afraid and terrified, because they thought they were seeing a ghost. But Jesus said, "Why are you afraid? Why do you doubt? Look at my hands and my feet and see who I am. Touch me and find out for yourselves. Ghosts don't have flesh and bones as you see that I have." After Jesus said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. The disciples were so glad and amazed that they could not believe it. Jesus then asked them, "Do you have something to eat?" They gave him a piece of baked fish. He took it and ate it as they watched. Jesus said to them, "While I was still with you, I told you that everything written about me in the law of Moses, the books of the prophets, and in the Psalms had to happen." Then he helped them to understand the scriptures. He told them, "The scriptures say that the Messiah must suffer, then 3 days later he will rise from death. They also say that all people of every nation must be told in my name to turn to God in order to be forgiven. So beginning in Jerusalem, you must tell everything that has happened." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Judas,
yeah, he's the one who left. Why would you ever want to leave, Judas? Yeah, okay. Peter, yeah.
John.
Antonio, were you going to say John too? That was a good answer. We're up to three. Yeah. James, and we'll count that as two, because there's two Jameses, so we're up to five. We're doing awesome. Yeah, sorry, sweetie. Paul is a really special friend of Jesus. He calls himself an apostle, but he wasn't at the Last Supper. But we'll come back to Paul. We're still at five. Peter had a brother. His name starts with A, too. Okay, tell me your answer. Who did you say? Jacob? Joseph is Jesus' dad. That's what our church is named after, right? That's what your school is named after. But he wasn't at the Last Supper. He was already passed away at that time. So let's talk about Peter's brother. His name starts with an A. There's nobody in this group that has the same name. Andrew, that's right. Then there was a name that rhymes with Rilla. Philip, you see how I'm helping you? We're up to seven, right? Then there's one who's got a really long name that starts with a B. Do you remember his name? Do you remember it? Tell me. What did you say, Bethany? That's a place where Jesus visited. That's a really tough city to remember. I'm really impressed. But that's not the guy's name. I'm looking for his name. Matthew's one of them, yeah. That's right, the tax collector, yeah. Rhymes with Bartholomew. Kind of a tongue twister. Bartholomew, that's right. And then there's another one who Father Rico was born on his day. It's kind of like Judas, but his name's a little bit shorter. It's Jude, right? And then we have, who haven't we covered actually? Now I've got to think about it. Okay, you tell me. Who? Mark's a really special friend of Jesus too, but he's not one of the apostles. Yeah. So we covered it. We covered Peter and the two Jameses and John. We had Andrew, Bartholomew, Philip, Judas, Jude, Matthew. Who are we forgetting? Yeah. Luke's another special. You guys are covering all the evangelists. We're going to be here all day with the saints. Maybe you should just keep going. All right? Luke's a very special. I'm only laughing because it's a good answer. I don't mean to embarrass you. You're awesome. You're awesome. You've got all the evangelists. Let's just keep going. Oh, there we go. All right. That's called saving us, right? Yeah. So the 12 apostles were there, and Jesus wanted to gather them around his table. So he does this just before he does a very important thing. What did he do just after the Last Supper? What happened to Jesus after the Last Supper? He just celebrated it 3 weeks ago on a very special Friday. Yeah. Okay, sure, go for it. He went what? I can bring you. He went to go pray by a tree. That's right. This was actually Thursday night. Awesome. We call that the Garden of, it's kind of a tough word to say, Gethsemane. The Garden of Gethsemane. Father Rico actually visited there. It's a beautiful place where Jesus prayed. And he took three of his BFFs, Peter, James, and John, there to pray. That's good. But what happened on Friday? What happened on Friday? Yes. Before we got to Easter, that was Sunday. I love how we're jumping ahead, which is fantastic. That's why we're here. We're Easter people. But what happened on Friday? Yeah, he died for us. So he knew it was going to happen. So that's why we call it the Last Supper, because this was his last dinner with his friends. Now, did he serve pizza and Pepsi at the Last Supper? What did Jesus serve at the Last Supper? Because this is important, because we do it every single Mass. Bread and wine, that's right. Because this is what they ate at the time. Do you guys have wine? Well, we shouldn't have wine, but if you're Italian like me, we have a little bit, right? When we're little kids. But bread and wine, right? And then Jesus changed the bread into what? This is very important that we know this. Yes. Changed the bread into what? You're ahead of me. You guys are always 3 steps ahead of me. He changed the wine into his blood, right? What did he change the bread into?
his body. That's right. And he says, every time you do this, you are eating me, my flesh and blood, so I can be a part of you. Your whole life, friends, you've been waiting, right? Most of you are 7, some of you are 8, depending on your birthday. You're waiting your whole life. Come out for the blessings, you roll your eyes. I don't want a blessing, I want Jesus, right? Well, today is that day where he's going to come into your heart for the very first time, which is so awesome. That's why it's important to be at Mass every week, because Jesus wants to come into our heart every week. He says, unless you eat my flesh and drink my blood, you have no life in you. But those who eat my flesh and drink my blood will live forever. Raise your hand if you want to live forever. Some of our parents don't. Yeah, we think I'm talking to all of you. And everyone at home, I know your hand is up too. Right? Yeah, we all want to live forever. Because the tomb is empty. Jesus is alive. That's why Easter is the best time of the year. Okay? Even though Christmas seems like the best time of the year, it's not. Easter is the best time of the year. Why? Because Jesus is alive. And so, while it looks like bread, smells like bread, tastes like bread, is it bread? Looks like wine, tastes like wine, smells like wine, is it wine? It's the body and blood of Jesus. Now, raise your hand if you like to eat. I'm going to raise both so God sees me as an Italian. Yeah, eating's awesome, right? Why is it important to eat? What does food do for us? Yes. Gives us energy to run. Keeps us alive. Keeps us healthy. Is your hand up or your fist here? Okay. What else? Why? Sorry, sweetheart. What did she say? I didn't say. Keeps you healthy. Yeah, that's a good answer. Yeah. It tastes good as well. Yeah, that's true. I agree with that. Yeah. Sure. Helps you to grow. That's right. So Jesus wants us to stay healthy and help us to grow. So it seems like yesterday, right, parents? Remember when you brought your son and daughter into the church for the first time? Did we see sacrament number one? Do you remember what your first sacrament was called? Starts with a B. Trying to spread out the wealth here. Okay. Yeah, baptism. That's the first sacrament we receive. Many of you, if not all of you, were baptized from this special font, unless you live somewhere else. But that's okay too, because every font is special. And so what happened was, as the priest or the deacon or the bishop poured holy water over you, your soul began to grow. Then you received sacrament number two, just a short while ago. What was that sacrament? Sacrament number two. Yes, reconciliation. That's right, where we said sorry to God for the first time, right? Now our hearts are ready to receive sacrament number three. So what he wants to do is he feeds our souls. Because what happens? How many times do you eat a day usually? This could be a dangerous answer for high smackers. Father, we like snacks too, especially the healthy ones. How many times do you eat a day usually? Minimum of? Sure. Three, right? Breakfast, lunch, and dinner. What happens after you have breakfast? Do you get hungry again around 12 o'clock? Yeah, then when you have lunch, you get hungry around, I don't know, 5, 6, 7, depends when mom and dad come home. Yeah, right? So we have to keep eating to keep our bodies strong as they grow. Well, more importantly than our bodies, because our bodies stay for a period of time. But inside our bodies is a soul that lasts forever. That's the part that goes to heaven first. Then once Jesus comes down for the second time, then our bodies are going to be raised up too. So our souls are what Holy Communion keeps us strong, so we can continue to be God's daughters and sons. So my prayer, friends, is that you will always remember today. Father Ivo said that 31 years ago I received my first Holy Communion. I remember that day. It was a very special day where my mom and dad and my two brothers, the rest of my family were there, just like the rest of your families watching us online, moms and dads, your brothers and sisters. which is so great, right? And they pray for us so that way our hearts are open to Jesus, that we will continue to grow as we receive sacraments. Four, that our grade eights just received confirmation the last 2 weeks, and then maybe you'll be called to get married, or maybe some of you will call to be a priest like me, or maybe you'll be called to be a nun, which is so awesome too. And then the sacrament of the sick, when we get old and we get ready to meet Jesus. Those are important. But as we grow, friends, my prayer for you is that today will not just be a special day today, but every time we receive Jesus, that same excitement you have today, something that I got to receive even 31 years later, every time. I go to church every day. I'm a priest. That's what I do. I love it. Each time we receive communion, new parents, we have that same vigor, that same excitement that your son and daughter has, for we are receiving not a symbol, Jesus himself. And it is your responsibility, moms and dads, you made this promise of baptism, to bring your son and daughter, bring me, more important than feeding them with pasta or rice or burgers and fries or whatever you guys like to eat, right? More importantly is that our souls are fed by he who is the source of life. So friends, know that Jesus has a very, very, very big smile on his face today. That you will receive him for the first time. May this be a time of grace for you as he touches your heart in a special way. And so with great love, we continue to say, thank you, Jesus. Let us stand together as Jesus' friends and proudly profess our faith in him using the words of the Nicene Creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the world to come, the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. My brothers and sisters, with great confidence, we break our knees,
trusting that Jesus always listens to our prayers. And so I invite Elliot and Xavier, Jacob, Emily, Mateo, and Harlan forward to lead us in our
give us this day our daily bread. Give us this day our daily bread. Give us this day our daily bread.
May our parents incite each Sunday as your special day, bring us to church so that we may receive our often Holy Communion. We pray to the Lord.
Give us this day our daily bread.
Lord our God, who are so good to us, you listen to these prayers and give us your very flesh and blood to eat and drink. Help us to grow as Easter people, celebrating the joy that comes from you. We ask these and all things through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Let us be seated now while our altar is prepared, and I invite our gift bearers, Jaina, Antonio, Abby, Maya, Sophie, and Jacob to the back to bring forth our gifts. For through your goodness we have received this bread which we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
By the mingling of this water and wine, we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For through your goodness we have received this wine which we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, Lord. May our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Wash me, O Lord, of my iniquity. Cleanse me of my many sins. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Amen. Let us stand together. Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings from your church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in happiness in heaven, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. My brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
God our Father, you have brought us here together so that we can give you thanks and praise for all the wonderful things you have done. We thank you for all that is beautiful in the world and for the happiness you have given us in this Easter season. We praise you for daylight and for your word which lights up our minds. We praise you for the earth and all the people who live on it, and for our life which comes from you. We know that you are good. You love us and do great things for us. And so with all the angels and saints, we sing together this song of joy. When supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice that was filled with wine. He thanked you and gave it to his friends and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of
We proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come.
as we receive the body and blood of your Son, Lord, you never forget any of your children. We ask you to take care of those you love, and we pray for all who have died. Remember everyone who is suffering from pain or sorrow. Remember Christians everywhere and all other people in the world, too. We are filled with wonder and praise when we see what you do for us through Jesus your Son, and so we give you praise. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Turn and offer one another a sign of the Lord's peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy to enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
For those at home receiving Jesus in a spiritual communion, Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament.
I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Friends, now as you prepare your hearts, you will be called one at a time around the altar of God. And so, as you approach, know that it is Jesus who feeds you with his very self.
The Lord Jesus calls for the first time, Harlan.
Harlan, the body of Christ. Your mask, my friend. Thank you.
The Lord Jesus calls for the first time, Mia.
Mia, the body of Christ. Altar hands, altar hands.
The Lord Jesus calls for the first time, Elliot.
Elliot, the body of Christ.
The Lord Jesus calls for the first time, Abby.
Abby, the body of Christ.
The Lord Jesus calls for the first time, Jacob.
Thank you.
Thanks be
God. Alleluia, alleluia.